continuing the journey. And HK... What a way to start. HK-47 is on the floor because T3 took him out. Well, that's it, guys. HK-47 is dead. Should probably check on him, though.
Query. He's the...
Okay, he just popped up on the floor. Okay, what a way to start. See if I need any wisdom.
Yes. Have you come with questions?
I want to know. Well, let's check the crystal first.
That crystal is bonded. Should your power. Okay. Is there something else you.
Don't need any upgraded, but I want to know. When Beast attacked me, she did something to my eyes.
She did nothing to your eyes that was not already there. She has forced this upon you, but such crude methods are the markings of the Sith. Close your eyes.
What?
Close your eyes.
Okay.
Feel this ship around you. The welding of the droid as it goes about its work.
Hey, T3 has a stuck motivator.
Now, stretch out. Hear the rumble of hyperspace, the hum of the hyperdrive.
I can hear a catch in it. It's not fully fixed.
Ignore distractions and focus on my voice. The breathing of the blinded one as she meditates in the dark. Now, listen deeper past her breathing and listen.
As my feet walk from the ashes of Katar, I shall not fear. For in fear lies death. And
I heard her thoughts.
You are strong indeed. What you heard were surface thoughts only, but it is something that masters have trained for years and never learned.
How did I do that?
That is not the real question you should ask. Is such listening enough to perceive the world around you? It is not. Because to listen to the thoughts of another is much like attempting to see the universe only with your eyes. It is equally limiting. Now leave me be. I must rest. Yes?
I should probably do the lightsaber combat. I need 2 lightsabers, 3 of them. 2 of them for myself, like the blue one, and 1 for Visas.
Yes.
I think that's how it works.
Very well.
Yeah, that's how it works.
If you travel with us, Blinded One, then you shall work for your passage on this vessel. Your lightsaber, give it to me.
I shall die before it passes from my hands.
Your lightsaber, give it to me.
The crystal I took from the condensed mist, Sanka.
It is adequate. You are young. Your energy for such things surpasses mine. And your skill is enough that you may teach her the basics of the weapon. There is much she has forgotten.
There's only so much I can teach her.
That fact did not escape me. Now, try to kill her with the single blade. Use no other force technique, no items, merely the blade.
All right, let us begin.
Now, do it with 2 weapons, 1 in each hand. Again, no items. No force powers. Let us see what you can do when your hands and mind are divided. No force techniques other than weapon skill. Let it flow. Let the force fill the cracks in your spirit.
2 blades did. Okay.
Now, divest yourself of your weapons. You, Blinded One, you will keep yours. Let us see what you can do when you have no weapons left to you. Now, attack her.
Alrighty.
It is enough. Huh. There is nothing more for me to teach you. You know as much of battle as I.
Of course I do. Nice. Purple one is mine. The blue one is for Beodor. I should give Vesis the lightsaber, though. Don't worry. Adam will get his. Fuck. Alright, let's go to Onderon.
Very well, proceed.
It's not an interrogation.
Statement. Very well, Master. But if you wish to be brutal and vicious about it, know that I am trained for such things. Do your worst.
I meant questions.
Statement. Master, I am no behavior droid, but it is obvious to me that you have serious ethical problems that will need to be treated at some point. Very well. Ask your questions. If you feel the need to make it an interrogation, however, do not restrain yourself. I would be saddened if you held back.
So the most important one I want to be asking for now is, do you know anything about the Sith hunting us?
Answer. No, Master, I do not. I am afraid I have been out of touch with the Sith for many years. This new Sith threat fights differently than the ones I was familiar with. These seem to favor stealth and assassination to achieve their ends.
Do you know where they'd be striking from?
Answer. No, Master. The Sith had many hidden bases and strongholds before and during the Jedi Civil War, and I doubt the Republic found them all. Theory. It is possible that the Sith still hold one such base, if not several. Consolation. But I would not worry, Master. I imagine it will not be long before their murderous hands try to seize you by the throat. Twi'lek metaphor.
Jonta bosi ligida masi soringada untamiasa grawino roto.
Well, yeah, well, crack beetles are a lot smaller than our enemies.
Query. Master, excuse me. One thing I have noticed as we travel the galaxy. You seem to possess the ability to understand a variety of alien languages. Forgive me, but that does not seem in keeping with my assessment of your talents.
It's the sonic imprint sensor on Paragus. It doubles as a translator.
Query. May I see it?
Sure.
Observation. This is indeed familiar. Indeed, it seems to be modeled after my vocabulator, with some modifications, of course. Curious. You say you obtained this device on Paragus?
Yep. Before the planet was destroyed.
Observation. Master, I do believe this device serves multiple functions, including tracking your position for any HK units in the vicinity.
And what should we do with it?
Observation. Master, I do believe this device serves multiple functions, including tracking your position. It is sending out a passive carrier wave that signals itself to HK units in the vicinity.
That explains how the HK units keep finding us. So we just wait?
Answer. Master, the nature of the signal from the sonic imprint sensor is such that we must wait until it is signaled. It does not please me any more than it does you. But one of the primary traits of an assassin or assassin droid is patience.
Hmm. So we'll be able to find their HK factory if we get ambushed by three groups of assassin droids. Now we go to Onderon. I'll be back on Nar Shaddaa, though. So many ships.
Well, this is Onderon. Looks like there's a long line to get into the Isis starport.
Something feels wrong here. A great disturbance here in orbit, and again on the planets below.
I guess this blockade is a symptom of larger problems on Onderon.
If they decide to do a cargo search, we're gonna be in trouble.
Looks like we're about to find out. I'm receiving a message from some Colonel Tobin. Patching it through.
The Ebon Hawk. I was told to expect your arrival. I don't know your business on Onderon, but it ends here.
Uh-oh.
We've taken some hits. We can try to fight back, or I can outrun them and hide us on the jungle moon nearby. It's your call.
I'll man the turret. Just keep her steady. I'm getting on the turret, baby! Still got it. Oh, fuck. Jesus Christ. Okay, just one more. Got him.
I can't keep us in one piece much longer. Sorry to spoil your fun, but we've got to land now. I'm gonna put us down on that jungle moon.
You know, just once I wish someone was glad to see us. But no, if it isn't weapons pointed at our heads, it's someone trying to blast us out of the sky.
I remember the days when welcoming committee used to mean something, without being followed by blaster bolts.
So what now?
Well, the space battle's still going on overhead. Since they were so eager to use our hull for target practice, I doubt they're just gonna forget us. Well, I don't like it. Onderon is about as far from the core as you can get and still be in the Republic. But even out here, the locals have heard of us.
We're lucky I was able to find this place to land. Looks like something has cleared away the jungle in a few spots around here.
Where did we land, though?
Looks like one of the moons of Onderon. Not sure which one. It's mostly jungle and mountain. I did pick up the remains of an old outpost near here. Maybe that's why there's all these clearings around. Maybe they were once settlements.
There were no settlements here. Those clearings were most likely once craters or crash sites.
Crash sites?
This is Duxon, where the Mandalorians began their crusade against the Republic. The remains of whatever outposts you detected here are military ones. We should be careful.
This is where the Mandalorian War started? This doesn't look like much of a battlefield.
Much is buried here, and there is much that should remain buried.
How badly is the ship damaged?
It's taken a little damage, nothing too serious. I'm shutting down all unnecessary systems until we make repairs. It'll keep us from being a target.
We need to get to Onderon, though.
Until the ship is repaired, we're not going anywhere. Unless you can find another route to Onderon, we should sit tight.
There may be a means to get to Onderon by another route. The Force has guided us here for a reason. We should explore our surroundings. There is something here.
Something? Oh, there's something here, all right. Predators. Not small flit darters, but big, mean, nasty predators.
Nevertheless, we should explore our surroundings. And that nearby outpost would be as good a place as any to begin.
Let's head to the outpost, then.
Well, if you go, be careful. No telling what other ships were forced down in the battle.
I have a feeling the ship will not be repaired until our business here is concluded. Do I make myself clear?
Yeah, I understand. What's so important about this place?
This is where the Mandalorian Wars began. She fought here once, and there are things here she must see.
She fought here? Why didn't she say anything?
Do you speak of all your battles? Or are there some you wish to forget?
Huh. Leveling up to do, so yep, better get started. Seven more. I'm just adding random skills, to be honest. I'm mostly focused on my skills. Two more after this. Jesus. Excuse me. Mm-hmm. let's move on. Gotta speed up. Just gonna kill him. Those Canucks. I wish I had force jump, but I'm not a Jedi Guardian. In the middle of my battle.
Sensors just picked up a contact heading to the moon. Most of the ship's systems are powered down, so it's about all I got. That ship may have landed nearby, though, or it may be on the other side of the moon. So you might want to prepare for another friendly Onderon welcome.
I shall make this one see.
This was a corpse during the Mandalorian Wars. There we go. Actually, let me change my skills. Yeah, we'll do this. Freeze. Prepare those droids for that sweet XP.
of the interesting treasures of what to get out of the Kanok. Charge.
The orbital fighting just ended. That Colonel Tobin stirred up a Minox nest when he took a shot at us. I'm still working on the repairs, and I have to take down some systems, including sensors. So you have to do without me for a while. I know, you're crushed.
Yes. What is that? Belts. I'll still take the tech support. Gives me lots of skills. In fact, next time I find a workbench, I need to upgrade my lightsaber. Oh boy. That means trouble. Thermal detonator. My first thermal detonator of the game.
Donos Emeragith, Wanara Orachi Drumta, Sain Chobin Sash, Dosimana Rochata, Eranamosimu and Asarans, Krema Sukunda Tungala.
Love that the droids have arrived to help me. So, who are you? Your family tried to kill me in Nar Shaddaa. So why are you hunting me exactly? Well, there's no way I'm going to surrender to you. Stab. All that loot. Oh god. Boma. To the deeper jungle.
You let the ship escape? I will deal with your failure later, Captain. But for now, find that ship. Our ally has indicated that the Jedi hasn't left the system yet. Send a detachment to Duxon. If you find anything, alert me immediately. Now get out of my sight.
Communications, recitation, and bring about the termination of hostilities.
Well, it's stunned already, Jesus.
Systems failing, monster.
Stop. That is not the skeletal remnant of a war long past. That is a recent kill. It appears that Duxon isn't as abandoned as we would be led to believe.
Why would the Mandalorians return here?
The past has a curious attraction to us all. Perhaps he came in a small shuttle to revisit old battlegrounds. Perhaps not. But let us press forward. You may find the answers you seek. This shall not stop us.
Campfire. And the fire's still lit.
Hold it right there. We've got you surrounded. I'm surprised you got this far. The jungle doesn't usually let its prey go that easily. What are you doing here?
What's with Mandalorians and this damned moon?
We claimed this moon decades ago, when we reforged ourselves after Exar Kun's defeat. Some of us call it home. Why are you trespassing here?
Interesting. I was thinking of starting a Zerka office here. Our ship crashed and we were forced to land here.
We expected as much. Few visit Duxon by choice. We have orders to escort you to our camp. Our leader wants to speak to you.
This may prove of use to us. Let us hear his words and see if they hold any value.
Very well. To the Mandalorian camp. Boy, whoever's leading this camp wants to rebuild the Mandalorians, it seems. Leader.
So you're the intruder. Our sensors picked up your handiwork in space. I am Mandalore, leader of the Mandalorians.
The game calls you Mandalore, but I'm gonna call you Kando the Mando, you son of a bitch. I thought the Mandalorians were disbanded.
Scattered, perhaps. But we're still alive. Alive and rebuilding.
Thought the Mandalorians were just blaster for hire.
Many Mandalorians have fallen from the path of honor and are now no more than common mercenaries. But that is changing.
Alright. What is this place?
This used to be the heart of the Mandalorian war effort. From this complex we commanded an armada that had the Republic on the run. It didn't last.
Why'd you use Duxton?
Mandalorians have a rapport with this jungle. Every moment here is a struggle. All creatures gripped in a constant war for survival. The sole purpose of the weak is to feed the strong. We train here and learn the lessons of the jungle. The beasts also help us keep our edge.
I see. Well, I'm trying to get to Onderon. Do you know how I can get there?
So it's transportation you want. It so happens I have a small shuttle that's more than capable of running the Onderon military blockade. I make occasional trips to Isis for information and supplies. If you want to go with me, you're going to have to prove your worth.
Alright, how can I prove myself?
Figure it out yourself. Ask around. See if you can make yourself useful, or something that'll show what you're made of.
So, there's nothing you can think of?
There is one thing. Before your ship landed, we were preparing some demolition work. All the activity forced my men to stop before they finished. The charges need to be detonated before anybody comes across them, so all you'd have to do is flip the switch.
Well, that sounds too easy.
You asked if there was anything you could do, and I told you.
True.
Nothing in this jungle is as simple as it seems, though.
Alright, I'll see what I can do.
I'll let Kex know that you check out. We found more gear than we can use, so you can trade with him if you need some more supplies. Be careful in the jungle. Our patrols have stopped until the space traffic dies down. The challenging beasts have been cleared from the area, but what's left might still be too much for you.
Nah. Alright, so I'm gonna try to do all the things for Mandalore. I'm a real warrior.
Jedi rely too much on their vaunted powers. They lose touch of the power of their arms and feet. Without your force, would you be a match for even the lowliest of Mandalorian warriors? If you want to try and fight us on our terms, that can be arranged.
Sure.
You are new here, so you will fight Davril. He is young and has not been able to prove himself in battle. Davril, what are your terms?
No weapons, no Jedi tricks, no items. Just fist and foot. A true test of strength.
Put your weapon away, Jedi. Don't step out of the circle and pull any death blow. No one dies in the battle circle. Step into the battle circle. Now you will experience a true fight.
A true fight, he says. Karate shit. Yeah. Damn.
The match between Jedi and Davril is over. The Jedi is the clear and honorable victor. Davril is just a recruit. I'm not surprised you won this fight. A challenger has expressed interest in fighting you. As little honor as you have gained, it is sufficient to accept his request. Let me know if you would fight again. Here to watch your fight. After defeating Davril, you have gained some small honor. There is a challenger for you. He is Kex, the quartermaster. Since he is the challenger, you get to choose the terms.
Alright, what would be appropriate?
The battle circle is for training. It is best to choose something that will test both of your limits. In this case, swords would be a good choice. It is something neither one of you are completely familiar with, but the choice is ultimately yours to make.
Let's fight with swords.
An honorable choice. I will send a runner to Kex. Your fight will begin shortly.
A dueling vibro sword. Jesus. Eat it.
The match between Kex and Jedi is over. The Jedi is the clear and honorable victor. If you want to fight again, let me know.
I could take them all on, no problem.
Here to watch a fight or... You choose to fight again. Now face a real Mandalorian warrior. Togrin, what are your terms? Just fist and foot like your fight with Davril. Tigran chooses to fight hand to hand. Remember, no weapons allowed, and absolutely no use of your force.
Force. He calls it force. Oh shit, he's getting serious. Jesus, kick my ass. Ugh. Oh shit. He did like the backflip shit. Oh, can I make it? I'm gonna start teaching you out. Yeah. Oh yeah, let's fucking go.
The match between Jedi and Tagrin is over. The Jedi is the clear and honorable victor. You have fought well today. The only Mandalorians left for you to fight are our champions. No one can fight a champion until they have proven themselves worthy. And it must be real proof. The kind you gain fighting foes to the death. And a champion must observe and deem your actions worthy. There are two champions in the camp, Braylor and Kelborn. Until you prove yourself in their eyes, the battle circle is closed to you.
All right, so I gotta go help a champion. Hey, Braylor, what's up?
So the Jedi Order isn't completely dead.
Nope.
You always had hidden strengths. Very hard for even the wisest Mandalore to judge and predict. I have studied much of the Jedi since our defeat. I would be honored to cross blades with you in the battle circle.
Can you vouch for me, though?
I could only do that if I observed you fight an enemy in real combat. I have seen your matches so far, and I do not doubt your worthiness to face me. But the rules cannot be changed. The other champion, Kelborn, is in the jungle on a mission. Perhaps your paths will cross, and you will have your opportunity there.
Very well. Alright, I know the workbench is right here, so let me create some upgrades. Cool. Nope, this is gonna... Some I want to take down, but I just don't want to break because they're so good. Not really into this whole obese environmental suit that I got from Nar Shaddaa. All right, want this? Do I have an expert? I think I do, but oh no, I don't. So good to craft it. Oh wait, that's right. The game made me unequip. That's okay. Since I leveled up.
Yes. That crystal should your power is that.
Okay. Still waiting for me to get a silver crystal so I can get my color to be silver.
You here to gloat over your victories in the battle circle?
Nope.
Save it for someone else. So why are you back?
I want to see what you sell. I do want that Mandalorian Ripper eventually. Problem.
This jungle attacks anything made by man. Restoring the generators and computer systems is no easy task.
I see. Well, I'm good both restoring computers, and yeah, I'm pretty good with the hydro spanner. Maybe I can help.
I'll take whatever help I can get. Whatever wires and tech haven't been corroded by the jungle are at least 10 years old. I'm trying to get the relay dish operational, but several components have broken and need repair. Without the relay, we're vulnerable to attack, especially right now. Your space battle may have attracted unwanted attention, and our shuttle sensors can't cover the whole moon.
Oh, then let's fix it.
Oh, seems just about everything involved with the relay dish is broken. I've been trying to fix it for weeks and still no success. If you think you can help, there's the broken cables right over there, and the relay maintenance structures behind me. You can find the telemetry computer in there. The only thing I know for sure is we need a new phase pulse converter for the tracking computer.
Where can I find one?
We actually already found one in an old weapons cache, but Flaming Canucks ate it.
They ate it?
That's a problem with Canucks. They'll leave you alone if you keep your distance. But if you turn your back on the pests, they'll eat anything they can get in their mouth.
Well, is there another way I can find it?
We checked the cache manifests, and that's the only one that was in storage. It's probably the only working converter on this moon.
Alright, how do I find it?
Just gut every Canuck you come across. You wouldn't believe the things you can find in those little beasts.
Gross. This better be worth it.
All right, then. Come back when you have the converter and we can see about getting these systems working again.
Spoiler, you don't. You gotta find 3 components, which is what I'm gonna be doing. But let me fix the wires. And fix the computer, or the relay dish. Rey has so many force abilities, I don't know what to do with her. Though.
We heard reports of a Zakeg wandering the paths around here. They're a good challenge for Mandalorians. If you see one, stay out of its way. Without us to back you up, you'll be dead in seconds.
Uh-huh. What's a Zakeg?
It's a huge red lizard that's built like a Baragwan battle tank. It has a hide so thick it might as well be Durasteel plating. We keep clearing them out of the area, but they keep coming back. They're tough opponents for are non-Mandalorians.
I can defeat it.
You fight a Zakeg. If you survived such a battle, you'd gain much honor.
No beast in this moon is match for me. I'll be back after I defeat one.
Strong words. It would be amusing to see you try to kill such a beast. Try the outlying jungle paths if you're determined to seek one out. And bring me back a trophy from your kill as proof of the deed.
Uh-oh. Oh, no. That's not good. I don't know why it crashed on me. Great. Oh, man. Alright. Oh, I'm back. Thank you, autosave. I thought I had to redo some progress. Okay, good.
You finally arrived, Jedi. I seek to reclaim the honor that you stole from me. I challenge you here, outside of the battle circle. This time, we fight to the death.
And why do you want to fight me again?
I was too young to fight in the Mandalorian Wars. With our plans scattered, there was no opportunity to prove myself. Years ago, young Mandalorians would fly point in a basilisk, laying waste to anything before them, at the forefront of battle. But this has been denied me. What little honor I have earned, you stripped from me in the battle circle. This I won't allow.
There's no dishonor in that, really.
You would deny my request? I want to fight here, in front of other Mandalorians, to prove my worth. Do not shame me further.
There must be other ways to prove yourself.
There were no wars to fight, no great enemies to destroy. I wish this was a different age, where our armadas were a force to be feared.
What about a Zakeg? I've heard they're a challenge even for a Mandalorian patrol.
A Zakeg? Those are the deadliest beasts in this part of the jungle. Patrols are right to be cautious about them. I'll do what I must to prove myself to the other Mandalorians, but fighting a Zakeg would be a short-lived honor.
I'm actually looking for one. We could fight it together.
What? Yes, I suppose that is possible. We would both gain recognition from that battle. Your plan is acceptable to me. Together we will destroy the Zakeg. I will meet you there.
Alright. I got a lot to do. Huh. Alright, got the converter. Now we just need two more parts.
See that Voma over there?
Yes.
The force flows through even these simple creatures. If you empty your mind, you may be able to feel its thoughts. They aren't fully formed. Basic instincts, urges, dominated by every breath and every moment, primal and unsophisticated.
I feel it.
Good. Beasts can be easier to affect than other sentients. But you must bridge the gap between what distinguishes us and them. You feel its consciousness, yes, like a low rumble before the storm. Use the force to create a barrier around it. Make it with care and subtlety.
I'll try.
You come close, and you have potential. With practice, you can make any animal passive and pliable. But the cage around their perceptions is a fragile thing. Violence, especially.
Can anything else be done with the beast? Or actually, thank you, I would never knew that.
The force is subtle and more powerful than people imagine. Keep an open mind.
King power beast trick. No wonder Kreia was way behind. She dealt with those Bomas by herself. Impressive. Plop.
You there, I am in need of your assistance.
Who are you? And what are you doing up there?
A patrol was sent to look for weapon caches in this region. They found three sites that looked promising. Zarka, my commander, told me to prove myself by taking explosives to those sites and uncovering the caches, if they exist.
So how did you get up there?
This was the first site. After easily dispatching some Maras, I removed my pack and began to plant my charges along this ridge. When I finished setting the charges, I looked down to see Canucks swarming all over my pack. The pests were eating everything. I killed the Canucks, but then a herd of Bomas arrived. I had no more ammo. The extra energy cells I had brought had been in my pack. So I've been up here, weaponless, for 2 days.
Alright, so how can I help?
You must have cleared a path to the beast coming here. If you take care of the Boma beast, I can make it to safety.
I could give you an extra ammo clip.
My blaster rifle's been useless ever since I used it to bash in a Canuck's skull.
I'll go drive off the Bomas, then.
Your actions are worthy of a Mandalorian. Return here when you have slain the beast, and I will be able to return to camp.
I just want to point out a funny option you can do. For all you evil people at home, a detonator.
Don't touch that button, it'll blow up all my charges.
You mean this button? I'll leave it alone then. But I want to press it.
I'm grateful for your help, stranger. I'm returning to the Mandalorian camp now. I won't forget this. I have only one request.
I can press the button now. Well, at least he was out of the blast site, I guess. Kill the Canuck. Alright, got the pulse converter. That's the second part. That's the Zakeg. So let's go kill it.
Zakeg is just up ahead. Together we have a chance of defeating it.
Okay, do you have a plan?
We go into the clearing and attack it. Either it dies or we do. Beasts of the jungle are fierce and powerful. Straightforward plans work the best.
I suppose. Then let's attack it now.
Then we fight.
Ba 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 ba.
I must thank you for your help. We have killed the Zakeg. I will leave the spoils of them. I'm going back to camp and will tell them of our deed here.
I got its ear for proof. Side of the camp. Let's see what else there is to do. Oh, this is where the beast ambush us. I saw that little frame, that frame delay right there. Thought you could ambush me. Ha! Huh. Feet should I get? I need to level up my two weapon fighting. What I think it is. Yep, it's the last part. Looks like the beast got disturbed by the explosion. See what this Mandalorian cache has to offer. Ooh, devastating mines. I'm just curious to see how much experience disabling those give me. Deal with all these droids. Yep. Nice. Gotta get all that loot. Possibly. Let's use a minor one. Don't want to damage it too bad. Interesting stuff so far. Oh, I guess I have to use the average. I wonder how much experience I get if I blow it up. Probably none, but I just want to make sure. Yeah, just making sure. Ooh. I think I got myself some better armor. Yep. It's actually good. Just by 1 point, but I'll take it. Almost missed this. I do like that immune to critical hits, so maybe I'll keep this. Awesome. All right, let's continue exploring the jungle. Double-bladed lightsaber. It is orange. Yeah! Nice. the camp.
What are you doing out here? It's dangerous for your kind.
I thought all the patrols have been stopped.
I am a Mandalorian scout. I don't go. Mandalore sent me out here personally to track a ship that landed in the area.
Found anything?
Just this corpse here. Looks like a scout. Pretty green, too. The fool walked right into a group of Canucks and got torn apart. He can't have been the only one crawling around here. If there's more, we need to take them out. You up for some action?
Sure.
Good to hear it. There's more of these scouts in the jungle. There's many paths, and I don't want them to slip by. If we split up, we should be able to find their scouts, if you're up for it.
Yep, let's find them.
I'm going to take up a position to the east. You go west. I'll make sure none of them get past me.
What happened to Lon?
He got swarmed by those little beasts. I think they're called Canucks.
I hope this mission is worth it to the Khan. If not... Wait, did you hear that?
That's her! Get her!
Looks like these scouts were looking for me.
Set the staging camp up here. This jungle just never ends.
Lieutenant, two of our scout patrols haven't reported back.
Do more? Nothing is worth this.
More beasts!
Everyone, attack!
I think we're done with everything in the jungle.
I found more of their scouts, but they started shooting as soon as they saw me. I heard blaster rifle fire coming from deeper in the jungle. You find anything?
I came across two groups of scouts. They weren't in the mood to talk either.
Surprised they wouldn't talk to you. I thought their grudge was only with Mandalorians. Find out anything useful from them?
Only that they mentioned something about a colonel. There also seems to be more of them.
Colonel, Could be Colonel Tobin. Tobin is General Vaklu's personal cat hound. If he's on your trail, you might want to steer clear of Onderon.
Yeah, but we're going there anyway, regardless. In fact, he forced us to land here.
I'm not surprised. He was probably acting on orders from Vaklu. If so, you've made some dangerous enemies.
Who is General Vaklu?
General Vaklu is the cousin of Queen Talia. He's also in charge of the Onderon military. He led the Onderon resistance when we occupied their world during the Mandalorian Wars. He was a worthy foe. Maybe more than a match for you. Mandalore needs to know about the scouts. I'll let him know your role in dealing with them.
So who were these scouts?
They're Onderon military, although they were trying to be secret about it. I've got a feeling you're going to need all the help you can get. One last thing about the battle circle. Your actions have proven you worthy of facing our best in the circle. Perhaps we can face each other there. See you at camp.
Yep. So, we gotta give the converter parts to the Mandalorian and go to the battle circle and give this guy the ear.
Davril has already told me of your battle with the Zakeg. You
robbed my men of a worthy test, but you have gained some honor for yourself in the process. You'd make a formidable Mandalorian.
He didn't really need the ear, since Davro already told everyone.
Any progress with the repairs or the phase pulse converter?
For all three parts.
You do? Let me see. I don't know how, but these pieces look in good enough shape to repair. I'll have the telemetry computer repaired in no time.
I'm just glad I could help out. Could you mention this to Mandalore?
I'll be sure to tell Mandalore how much help you've been. I know you didn't ask, but here's a reward anyway. Mandalorians are expected to do anything they can to help, but you're a stranger, and you didn't have to help us.
I don't need a reward. It's fine.
All right, if you say so. Again, you have my gratitude. Any progress with the
Both cables and telemetry computer are working now.
That's the best thing I've heard in weeks. I'll be sure to tell Mandalore about your help. Look, I have some extra parts and computer spikes. Take them. You can probably make better use of them than I can.
Just one computer spike and one parts. Nice. The fool let Kenox eat his equipment, then was trapped on a ledge by Boma Beast. What a dumbass. I'm just glad I was able to return him to safety.
We'll see if Kumas will prove warrior enough to be worth all this trouble.
Uh-huh. What the hell did they give me? I think that's the name of a weapon. It is not. What the hell did he give me? Might be armor. Yeah, it's armor. Weird name.
Kelborn says you are worthy enough to face champions. You may fight in the battle circle again. You have enough honor to face a champion of a previous day. Kelborn, what are your terms?
Swords only. No items or the Jedi's force. And no sword of the Jedi's choosing. Just a simple long blade.
Kelborn chooses to fight with the blade. You may fight with fist, foot, and the blade provided. No using the force or any other item.
All right. Yeah, take this pussy. Oof. Uh-oh. Ugh.
The match between Jedi and Kelborn is over. The Jedi is the clear and honorable victor. I underestimated you. A difficult admission for a Mandalorian. If you fight in the circle again this day, you will face the bravest and strongest of us, Braylor.
Might need to heal up.
Jedi with all of her arsenal.
Kralo will fight you as you are. Still, no killing and no leaving the battle circle. But you may use whatever else you want.
Alright. I don't give a shit.
The match between Jedi and Vraylor is over. The Jedi is the clear and honorable victor. You have defeated the most worthy of us. You walk away the champion of the battle circle this day. We will not forget your deeds, or the honor you have earned this day.
Let me see if I can find some upgrades for my armor. I wonder if I can upgrade any or create something. Armor. Interesting. It's always with tree injury the good stuff. I'll cut back on that later. Let's just use the ones I have for now.
Yes. That most interest is
okay. Time to upgrade the crystal.
Yes. Let me focus on the crystal for a moment. There, now it is fully in tune with you again. Is there something else you wish?
Alright. Glows moderately.
Prestige by helping Kumas. How many Kanoks did you have to kill to find those parts for Zuka? That was a tremendous help. I won't forget it. You've made quite a reputation around here. You did better than I thought you could. I was planning on heading to Isis tomorrow, but I'll move up the timetable and take you now. You won't be able to get to the Ebon Hawk from the city. If you need to grab anything from your ship, I'd do it now.
I've also set off the detonator in the jungle.
I know. It made quite a racket. Good work.
After I set off the explosive, I had to fight through a tough pack of Bomas.
That's to be expected. They don't really like it when someone makes loud noise in their territory.
So you knew it would happen.
It wouldn't be much of a test if all you had to do was take a hike through the jungle, now would it?
Huh.
You're alive, in one piece, and learn something about the beasts of the jungle.
Oh, a double-bladed lightsaber.
All scouts, report in.
I guess I can go now.
All scouts, report in.
I wonder. Nah, I'm not gonna make too much effort on that.
All scouts, report in.
Let's go to Onderon, or Isis, the city of Isis.
Are you ready to go to Isis yet?
Yep. What about the new, anything new about the sketch from Third Ship?
Kelborn told me that they were covert military and probably aligned with Colonel Tobin from Isis. Kelborn doesn't think they'll send out any more scouts, but that doesn't mean there aren't more of them out there. Colonel Tobin is General Vaclu's right-hand man. Despite his martial skill, he handles himself as a functionary more than a warrior.
Oof.
Back when we were fighting Vaclu's resistance during the Mandalorian Wars, Vaclu wouldn't have any use for a poisonous Kenrath like Tobin. But Vaclu seems to have adapted well to peacetime. Are you ready to go to Isis yet?
Yep.
I'm going to talk with Zuka and have him start a shuttle flight check. After that, we'll head out. How are the port stabilizers?
They check out Mandalore. All systems are green.
Good. I want the shuttle bound for Onderon within the hour. What do you want?
Is all in readiness?
It is. Like I promised. Why? You want to back out now?
My only concerns are for the one you escort to Onderon, Mandalorian. Would you do any less for one of your clan?
Don't pretend to understand us. We Mandalorians are a breed apart.
If by apart you mean scattered, broken, and lost, then yes, you are correct.
Not for long. Soon the Mandalorians will be strong again, united as one clan under one banner. Mine.
Ah, yes. The Great Crusade. After the first one was ended by Revan and the Jedi. Such a defeat was merciful, an echo of the end, when your ships were in flames, crushed in the grip of Malachor V. But I do not need to remind you of such things.
I was at Malachor V, and I remember how many Jedi died to stop us there. And no matter how many dead orbit that planet, the Mandalorians still live. Clan Ordo still lives. See Kex there? He was serving on Nar Shaddai's muscle for the Hutts. Kelborn was a scout for the Duros on Frontier Worlds. I brought them here, gave them a purpose. This galaxy will be ours again, I promise you. That is the future.
Indeed. The future is always in motion. It is a difficult thing to see. Perhaps there will be no New Age Mandalore, no great Mandalorian crusade. Perhaps your people fought their last battle at Malachor V, and you have been dying ever since, a quiet death that will last centuries. And perhaps all that remains will be what I see before me. A man wounded by a Jedi, encased in a Mandalorian shell, hunted by the thought of being the last of the Mandalorians.
You've got some guts talking to me like that. You think your age or your Jedi wealth are going to keep you safe from me?
No, Mandalore. You are wrong. I hope that it is you who will keep the one I travel with safe. You are loyal, and you have served many masters, even when they abandoned you. Do you wonder where he wanders now, Mandalore? Why he gave you your orders, then abandoned you at the edge of the galaxy?
How do you know that?
I know many things, and I can answer the question that burns within your shell, Mandalore. But there is a price. You must keep the one I travel with safe. She is important to me, more important than anything. Show the same loyalty you have shown in the past, Mandalore. If there is a Mandalorian crusade, let it be for something that will carry your people's memory into the future. So when the time comes when there are no more Mandalorians, then at least their honor will remain. The one I travel with has walked your same path, and I ask that when the end comes, that you remember that kinship, even if it seems there is nothing else left.
Hmm.
Forget the Jedi. Keep your eyes on her.
One, two, three.
Ooh.
Mandalorians, we've got company. Stealth targets have breached our perimeter.
Assassins.
Wait a moment. I sense there is a disturbance in the camp. Our enemy has tracked us here. I did not expect them so soon. How did they get here, I wonder? Regardless, we must eliminate them all. None of them can escape. Our whereabouts must remain a secret. Let us join the battle. Our allies will need our help.
So, going back on what Kreia has been saying, let me remind you that Mandalore is Kando Mando, also known as Candris Ordo. And apparently she knows why Revan abandoned him, like told him to do what he needs to do and then went to the unknown regions. I guess I wouldn't say, not the unknown regions, go do Revan stuff. Pretty sad. Alright, we gotta fight them. Charge! Damn, this one's tough. Jesus. Jesus, they're everywhere. Jesus Christ, they're everywhere. I know I've said this before, but damn. I get that experience.
I will silence this one.
Fight could stop any minute, so I gotta get as much experience as I possibly can. Why am I going back there? Yeah, that's what I thought.
Seems trouble follows you on a regular basis. I think it's best for both of us if we head to Isis immediately. Grab your gear. My men will take care of cleaning up the mess.
Never mind after beating a certain number of assassins. Nah, the fights just stop whenever the game tells you to. A little weird if you ask me. I got the Onderon.
Vaklu's saying that the Republic ship attacked first? That's madness!
Unfortunately, lie or not, it's a madness people will believe.
The timing of this is atrocious. A space battle above our skies, so many of our fighters lost?
Curiously, only Tobin's men were involved in that battle.
That shooter!
Strong word, Your Majesty. But there is no good time for news like this. I recommend we continue with our plan.
But won't that bring even more followers to Vaklu's side? Increasing his power?
For a time, perhaps. But we both know he's not the true threat. It's his unseen support from the shadows that we must drag out into the light. Then, and only then, can we strike.
I fear by then it will be too late.
Here we are, the city of Isis. It's been shut down tight for months now. General Vaklu is close to declaring martial law. We won't be able to travel too far in the city. Fortunately, I have a friend in this quarter of the city. He's a doctor by the name of Dagon Ghent. His office is on the other side of the market square. It might be best if you do the talking around here. The Onderonians have a mixed view of Mandalorians after we conquered them.
I have a test. Okay, so I can change parties whenever. That's good. It's only a couple instances where I'll be doing that. Since Mandalore will never become a Jedi, might as well, level him up. Let's get into toughness shit. We need to make sure he's good with blasters, too. So let's get precise shot. Okay, let's do this. 21, Jesus Christ. Got lots of work to do on that. I'm also going to work on his constitution as well. Just trying to make sure he's a good shot, that's all. Thank you. Sometimes she gets two. I forget sometimes.
It's been a while since you've docked here, eh? I suppose the lockdown has hurt your profits as well. Oh, it must be hard to shuttle people when nobody's allowed to leave. The blockade has been bad for everyone.
Mm-hmm. Any news on that blockade?
Nothing new. Our space forces have been in full readiness ever since the space battle in orbit. Tensions are running high. All Republic vessels must be searched. And the delays are turning pilots grey before their time. And ever since the Republic fired on our space forces, things have been even slower. Bad days. Bad days. And things are getting worse. I'd get out of the system quickly if I were your friend. Well, doesn't look like you have any trade goods, so the inspection's just a formality. Here's your starport visa. Don't lose it. They're priceless right now.
So what's a starport visa?
If you want to leave the planet, you need a starport visa. They're very hard to get. Many people want to get out of here before things get worse.
Alright, can I go now?
Certainly. Mind what I said about the starport visa. I know one captain already who can't get back into the starport.
What do you have for sale? All right, cool. Let's see what you got. The Gray Jedi Robe. You know what? Just for the hell of it, I'm gonna buy it. Just for the hell of it. Will I wear it? Maybe I will eventually.
Fair winds to you, Offworlder. Too much to hope that you are a Talosian merchant.
No merchant, sadly.
The winds still taste of misfortune. Our beasts will continue to wait in their cages.
Why do you have so many beasts in cages?
These beasts you see here are for delivery to Telos, but the Republic vessels that transport them have to wait for thorough and needlessly long searches. The city is stacked with caged beasts waiting for their ships. We have stopped gathering beasts now, but they still fill the city. For Drexel and Ryder, the Athorians brought wealth and prosperity. Our settlements prospered, but now...
Your beasts seem restless.
They have been kept in their cages for a long time. But at times, I feel as if something else is affecting them. Frightening them.
Beasts can be sensitive to the currents within cities and people. When such things are disturbed, the beasts may echo it.
Perhaps it is the city itself. Isis has fallen upon dark times, and tensions run high in the streets.
Well, I'll be gone now.
Calm. Calm.
What?
Uh-oh.
Run! The Boma is out of control!
Well, that was easy.
I don't know what to say. I had heard stories, but I assumed that they were fledgling riders, or simply tales that grow in terror. Not since my first Drexel have I lost control of a beast. I apologize profusely. Here, I give you these credits for the danger I put you in.
Thank you for the credits. They're not necessary.
Please keep them. It salves the shame my beast's behavior has brought me.
Do beasts often do this?
Absolutely not. But recently, things are not as they were. The beasts grow more agitated by the day. The stories say that the smoldering fires of city politics cast a smoke they can smell and breathe. They revert to their primal instincts. As you've just seen. When they get that way, not even a skilled beast rider can control them. As soon as I leave here, I will talk with my family. There is much to be discussed.
So, I'm gonna switch Kray out with HK just this one time, real quick.
Halt, off-worlder. You'll have to answer some questions before you go into the city. What is your business on Isis?
I don't think my business is any of concern of yours.
I don't think your business is any concern of mine.
Observation. Master, your powers of persuasion, without the use of pain or violence, is a mystery to me.
It's inside a city, HK. Otherwise...
Statement. Of course, Master.
While you're at it, tell him to forget he ever saw us. Could be useful.
Not only is your business not my concern, I can't seem to remember why I'm holding you up.
You'll let me go of my business and forget you ever saw me.
You should probably go about your business, whoever you are. Oh, don't lose your starport visa, otherwise you won't be leaving for a long while.
Move along. Oh yeah, we've done the impossible. We've made HK-47 light side. That's the power of influence, my friends.
Let's hurry this up. I want him escorted out of here quickly.
This is outrageous. I'm not a spy. I'm a journalist for Isis Com.
You're a Republic spy, and your propaganda will be silenced. We are taking you back to our barracks for interrogation.
But, well, you can't be serious. You accuse me of propaganda? I have proof that Vaklu is withholding information on the so-called Republic.
One more word of treason out of you. What are you looking at? This is none of your business.
Please, ma'am, help me. Vaklu's troops won't listen. I'm just a journalist, not a spy.
What's going on?
This spy has been using his position as a journalist to spread lies and dissent among our people. No doubt he's been up to other treasonous activity as well.
But that's just crazy. I was a member of the Resistance. I fought in the Mandalorian Wars.
Yes, and your disloyalty now deeply sickens me.
Do you have some sort of warrant?
A warrant? General Vaklu passed an edict giving the military broad authority to detain and question anyone suspected of treasonous activity. It was specifically meant for us to pick up spies like this before they could leave Isis or go underground.
Do you have any do you have proof of any sort?
That is classified military information.
Sure it is. How many other journalists are being rounded up today?
I don't have time to answer your barbed questions, off-worlder.
Well, I'll make sure the story gets out.
Men, let him go. We'll be back with a court order. Then we'll take him to the barracks. And you should watch yourself. You don't want to be known for siding with people like him.
I don't know how to thank you. I'm getting out of Isis now. Eventually they'll come back for me. After that, I have a feeling no one will hear from me again. Thank you.
Please tell me you're an off-worlder. You came from the spaceport, right?
Yes, I am.
But this is good news. You have a starport visa, right? I can only sell my best weapons if you have that. These soldiers ensure that I don't forget these formalities.
Watch it, Keg. The captain already has enough complaints about you.
No need to be alarmed, my foreign friend. Pay the soldier no heed. Pretend he isn't here.
I'd like to see your stock. Crystal fine, but no silver crystal. Abu. That's fine.
There must come a time when the Queen bows to the will of the people. The Republic has brought nothing but war and death. In our 50 years of flying their colors, we have had more war than the past millennia. Back General Vaclu in his effort to make her see reason. We do not need the Republic. They need our resources, our world, and our blood. For all that we have given, now we get nothing. The Republic is weak and falling apart. Its Jedi, whose fallen brethren have brought such misery to us, have disbanded. Let's be the first world to take our future into our hands. Are you with me?
Who, me?
Yes, you! It is up to each and every one of us to turn the tide, to take control of our future.
Well, not my concern. This isn't my home planet.
Leave here, off-worlder. My words are meant for the sons and daughters of Onderon. Your type continues to plunder our world, and we have nothing to show for it. Begone!
That's enough, Ponlar. If you keep this up, you're going to spend time in detention. You're coming awfully close to treason.
You can't silence me forever, soldier. But I'll keep my peace. For now.
I wonder what those droids want.
Unnecessary observation. You are eliminating many of us Jedi. But such actions only delay the inevitable. Annoying recitation.
Let us proceed to facilitate communications.
Recitation.
And bring about the termination of hostilities. Oh, fuck it.
Wanabota Ayuka Taigwa Kankidora Yasora Ku Tuka Ulwanji Yumali
Dahupa Bosa Kurata Go Juju Toyoki Hyata Yamba Wajiaki Yukito Kavadumba Munsuru Kuplaliawa Bo Bagaragawanda Yaitua Ulwanji Yuma
Mogachi Norta Hirembe Wanachi Kati Mogo Grabo Drum Pavanakaras Mangra
Kawana bota yunta tanga kinamatura. Ta yaita ta bosana nansata.
Okay, what do you think of Queen Talia?
Kawana bota ayuka taigwa kankidora. Yasora ku tuka ulwanji yumalifa.
Kavadumpa munsuru kuplaliawa. Bo bagaragawanda yaitua ulwanji yuma. Kawana bota yuta tanga kinamatura.
I don't know much about General Vaclu.
Fereki mangradu noko herete jun sombo marampi no su klela so buto.
Taracho mo sincho kavavolpa muleji kumanaminta barawamba. Kawana bota yuta tanga kinamatura. Ta yaita ta bosana nansata.
Ondolal no saka. Mangra.
Who do you trust more?
Kawana bota ayuka taigwa kankidora. Yasora ku tuka ulwanji yumalifa.
Variki, mangra, do cha, screeni do pat. Slime nun kwahiriti. Kawana bota yunta tanga kinamatura. Ta yaita, ta bosana nansata.
So
basically, Vaclu's a liar.
Dorjine soba wata.
Unta chivita inka ki kraya na chawanga kone.
Trusting your leaders is crucial. I'd rather support Queen Talia.
Kawana bota ayuka taigwa kankidora.
Dahupa, bosa kurata, go juju toyo.
Okay, so I know I say I support Queen Talia, and I really do. I'm gonna support her in this game. But for a couple of influence opportunities with Mandalore, I have to do a couple things.
I won't remain silent any longer. The Republic has actively attacked us. They attack our spaceships unprovoked. What next? An invasion? Perhaps they seek to conquer us. Will you stand idly by? Will you let them bomb our city?
No!
If Queen Talia is so removed that she won't do what the people so clearly want, then we must show her with force.
That's it, Ponlar. We're taking you in. You've gone too far.
Brothers and sisters, let us rise up now and march to the palace. Our will cannot be denied.
Everyone join Ponlar. The queen's reign must end. Mwahahaha.
That's right! Death to the queen! Death to the rise! Grab arms! We will march!
Why are you joining in this? I prefer Vaklu over Talia, but this is hardly a task for a warrior.
If we want to work with Vaklu, we need to give him some sort of sign.
I hate to lower myself to joining this mob, but your plan may work.
You would fight with them? This is madness! We need reinforcements!
The Offworlder joins us!
Let's fight these rats!
The rules must die!
Damn. This is all for influence. I'm not gonna support General Vaklu in this. It's all about deception, you know? Stab. Slash. Swish. Another influence opportunity with Mandalore we can do by talking to her.
The rumor I've heard is that you don't fully agree with our queen and her supporters. If you aren't adverse to Queen Talia stepping down, we could use your help. It would be quite worth your while.
Alright, what's this about?
I am a strong supporter of General Vaklu. The merchant quarter is an important area, not only financially but strategically as well. It is one of the few districts that is directly connected to the royal palace. The Queen and her advisors are well aware of this and have ensured that the captains here are extremely loyal to her. This presents complications for Vaklu. If you could arrange for them to be removed from their command, you will be richly compensated.
Alright, how do I remove them from their post?
You can't attack them directly. The entire city would be after you if you assaulted their checkpoints.
Obviously.
You may have to be subtle and patient. They don't have to be killed, just removed from command.
Not gonna do this, by the way. This is just for influence shit.
There's Galisi at the starport. Ryken commands from the turret tower. And Bastuko guards the entrance to the sky ramp. All loyal, and all need to be reassigned. He's the most junior of the captains. His superior, Captain Sulio, met with an accident. I believe you're familiar with that. Besides his strong loyalty to the Queen, I know next to nothing about him. He sometimes frequents the local cantina when he isn't at his post. He's been responsible for the merchant quarter for years. He's been chastised repetitively for his criticism of General Vaklu. His years of service won't protect him if he continues to subvert the chain of command. He has received several warnings. With a nudge, he just may get a dishonorable discharge.
Mm-hmm.
A true veteran, years of honorable service, completely dedicated to the Queen. Sadly, I think he's more on our side than the Queen's. But he's an old soldier that can't adapt to today's complex situation. Regardless of what the best interests of Onderon are, he won't swerve from executing the Queen's misguided decrees. Persuasion may be ineffective. Take this military security card. It can be used to slice into security terminals. Perhaps you'll find solutions there. About what?
How much does it pay?
For each task you complete, I am prepared to pay you 2,500 credits.
Ooh.
Plus, you will earn the favor of some powerful people. We could make your job much easier here.
Mm-hmm.
We should get General Vaclu to be on our side. He has a shrewd mind and is far more fit for command. Queen Talia is young and too idealistic. A veteran leader is what this planet needs, and would make a better ally.
I agree. Not really, but...
Vaclu is no fool. Even if we've had disagreements in the past, he'll recognize how advantageous an alliance could be between us.
Huh. Should probably save.
Tinachara, Granacha, Ganoiso, Totorano Kran, Rakichisa, Donacinto Norokipas Shakani, Rakichisa, Donacinto Norokipas Shakani, Dakosha, Nichotolo, Punta Chakorzo Wama, Gotashjuna Rananashani, Jumkarataka, Chonobograwe, Katia Bahasanchan.
Not really. Holy shit. The lightning. Let's just see if I can rewire you to be a little bit more helpful.
Reinitializing complete. Greetings. Do you have any interest in my goods?
Give me your components for free.
That goes against my primary behavior programming. All items must be sold based on the most favorable market conditions. 1B8D cannot haggle. This is also a part of my primary behavior matrix.
Quest access for market conditions, change all, multiply by zero.
Market conditions all set to zero. All prices now set to base cost value.
Cool. Not really good stuff, but what do I know? Go buy that. Yeah, just that.
This is Dagon Gent's place. He's not the best doctor you'll ever meet, but he's well connected in this city. Doesn't look like he's here right now, though.
You looking for Dagon? You're not gonna find him here.
Where is he?
A soldier captain was murdered at the cantina real good. They got some suspects at the tower. From what I hear, Dagon Gent is one of them.
Could Dagon have done this?
He's certainly capable of it, and probably stupid enough to get caught. But we need him, suspicion of murder or not.
What tower?
It's the turret tower on the other side of the market. Captain Riken is the man to talk to.
Thanks for the info.
If you talk to him, tell him I got his 20 credits.
More bounty hunters.
Woo!
We
We some mogo dosi sheba dente school in Mostovi gita yavach, piktareshan, bram taba nin sochu. Da come jus mak miki baranye doso so.
And how do you know me?
Yatuka, uwanurika, chotin, wanima, orata wakata, chu, kabadumpa, mo wendido chokerembi norta kunyun wish chawakachuba.
I got this. Time to loot. I got a starport piece. I wonder who could be interested in a starport visa.
We have found them again.
Have we, Tobin? Or is this a preface to another of your failures? Consider the whole field, Tobin. Why would a Jedi risk all of this just to come to Isis?
The crew of the Ebon Hawk is elusive, General. We were warned about that, but we still underestimated them. But the fools are here, in Isis. The intel on this is certain. I'm ordering men loyal to us to take care of them now.
I think I have an idea. Hold that order. Have her watched instead. The Jedi may prove a solution to another one of our persistent problems.
I think I could be useful, eh? Well, I'm light side, so you're wrong.
Welcome to what must be the smelliest place in the universe, Off-Worlder. How can I assist you?
Well, at least he's honest about it, I guess. You have a man named Dagon Gent in the custody?
We certainly do. He and several other people were picked up in connection to a murder.
Who got murdered?
Captain Sulio. She was in charge of the Starport checkpoint. A good soldier. Your friend was one of the last people that saw her alive. So far, he's just a suspect. But if he did it, the punishment is death.
Dagon Gent is the only person I know with the contacts to help us out. We need to get Dagon out of custody.
Okay. How long is he going to be questioned?
Until we either eliminate him as a suspect or find the real killer. Dagon has quite a record with the authorities. The Colonel thinks that murder isn't too far a stretch for someone like him.
How can I eliminate him as a suspect?
I know Dagon personally. He's one of the worst doctors I've ever heard of. But I can't see him deliberately killing someone. He was one of the last people seen with Captain Sulio in the cantina. Ask around there. I've heard he's got a good motive for killing her. If you can somehow clear that up and prove it wasn't him, Command will cut him loose. If I say any more, I'll get in trouble. Stay out of trouble.
All right, time to save right here. And I'm gonna call it a part.